Extra R&B. Extra Hip Hop.
One Extra.
BBC Radio One Extra.
So who recognises this? Not even the people singing before me. Amazing. There'll be some hardcores out there that are listening that will be like, yep, totally.
Yeah.
So I am joined by two of the gorgeous, young and sexy cast of Merlin, BBC's big show on Saturday night. I'm with Rupert Young, who plays Sir Leon, and I'm with Angel, who plays Gwen, a.k.a. Guinevere, if you're into the old school stuff. Should we have a little clip to jog your memory?
My lords, may I be granted permission to address the court?
Guinevere.
Prince Arthur taught me long ago that every citizen of Camelot is important. He would never stand by and let them suffer. He would help them if he could, and we must do the same.
I feel the pain as much as you, but we don't have a choice. If we keep letting people in, our food will run out within days.
You are wrong.
Perhaps you would enlighten me.
Those outside the gates are landowners, farmers. For days, the refugees have been bartering their wares with the townsfolk in return for the safety of their hearths. They bring with them far more than they take.
But how long before these wares run out?
3 days ago, Prince Arthur embarked on a quest to rid us of these creatures. At worst, we have another 3 before he reaches his goal. Or do you think he will fail?
I love it. So I'm with Angel, who plays Gwen. I just love the fact that she's all like, oh, so proper.
I know.
So
I
worrying. Everything's so worrying.
She does worry a lot, Gwen. She's a bit of a worrier. I think she needs to chill out sometimes. But yeah.
So just in case people haven't watched it, can you give us a synopsis? I know it's been going for a little while. It's pretty damn popular.
Yeah, it's done really well. It's kind of a before they were famous version of the Arthurian legends.
Right.
So it's kind of before we've actually reached our destiny. Arthur, Merlin, Guinevere and Morgana are all the same age, and nobody knows that Merlin's got magic, and it's illegal in Camelot, so
nice.
Keep it secret.
It's very magic orientated.
Indeed.
Rupert, tell us a little bit about your character.
I play Sir Leon, who is one of the knights of the Round Table, and yeah, I'm basically Arthur's right-hand man and a confidant.
You kind of add a bit of foie.
I like to think so, yeah. If I can.
You I are do. The knight in shining armour.
There you go. Not literally today, but yeah, yeah. I am.
And is it heavy? Do you have to wear like all these heavy
bits? It is quite heavy, I have to say. Like when it's kind of evenly kind of put on, it's fine. When you're holding it, it's quite heavy. And it's but the swords are heavy and but it makes you feel quite tough.
Oh, you love
you
it.
You can't complain.
I can see such a testosterone-filled twinkle in your eye right now.
It's brilliant, generally.
All the knights around the table. A lot more men in it.
And, yeah.
And do you get a similar kind of kick out of wearing that really sort of mystical period dress?
Yeah, I quite enjoy it. I quite like my more sort of action-y outfits, actually, which is kind of when Gwen goes off on quests and stuff, she gets to wear trousers and sometimes hold a sword, which is quite exciting.
Nice. In fact, it was a bit similar when I do these kind of set gate crashes and I went to the set of Downton Abbey.
Oh, yeah.
And Jessica, who plays Sybil, gets to wear trousers because she's a bit of a suffragette.
Yeah.
It's all very exciting.
Yeah.
It's like a lady wearing trousers.
I know, risque.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. So what is the best thing about being in Merlin if it's not the swords and the armour and all the rest of it?
God, there are so many things, really. I think... it's just a fantastic group of people.
Yeah, I was going to say that.
But also you're living I've said this before in things, but living your childhood dream. You know, you're holding a sword, you're sitting on a horse, and you're killing baddies.
Nice.
So it really doesn't get better than that.
Yeah.
And were you kind of into the urban myth of the Merlin tales before you were asked to be a part of the cast?
I had seen a few things. I hadn't necessarily read any of the books, but I'd seen, like, The Sword in the Stone was one of my Disney films. Yeah, I loved that. I know that's, like, not particularly highbrow, but still, that was probably my first foray into the legend.
Don't worry about highbrow here, babe. Don't worry. It's quarter past 2 on a Thursday afternoon.
Yeah, exactly. That is true. But then I also saw something, a series called Merlin, actually, with Sam Neill.
Right.
Which was on, I think, Channel 4 or BBC. Anyway, but I loved that. I thought it was amazing.
And you've been in it for a while, haven't you?
I've been in it since the beginning, yeah.
So we're in season 4 now.
Yeah.
And it's only but risen in watchers.
Yeah, absolutely. It's done really well. And it's kind of, it's on all over the world and stuff as well, which is amazing, which we didn't necessarily expect. So
cool.
Yeah, we're proud. We're proud of it, I think.
And where do you film?
We film in Cardiff most of the time. There's a big studio there. But we also film in France. There's a big castle there, which is quite cool.
The chateau.
Yeah, the chateau, which a lot of people think is CGI because it looks so kind of spectacular. Yeah. And it really is there. The first time you visit it, it's just brilliant. It generally is amazing. A lot of people come out to see it.
How fun is that?
Oh, it's amazing. It really
is.
Yeah.
Yeah, we get, like Rupert saying, we get a lot of fans now coming to visit, because obviously when we first started filming, nobody really knew what was going on or who we were. But now people come to see us filming, which can be a bit daunting. You've got hundreds of people watching you. It's like being on the stage or something. It's a bit weird.
And it's always that thing as well. I mean, if they're genuinely dedicated fans, you've got to kind of represent, haven't you?
Yeah, yeah, you've got to be. But people have cameras all the time. So, you know, you kind of might be walking on with your skirt, like stuck in the back of your knickers or something, and then people will get pictures of you.
That always happens to me.
Time, yeah.
My mother loves it though, because she can keep tabs on me the whole time, because all these fans take photos and she's like, oh, I saw what you were doing today, you ate an apple. And it's brilliant. For her, it's great. I do other things as well as eating apples.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Once had a banana.
You're working really hard. Very hard. In a big castle in
France.
It's
a character thing. I hate apples, but Leon loves them.
What's the typical hardcore Merlin fan like?
About 4 foot.
No, do you know what? Often they're adults, quite a lot older than you might expect. I don't know.
You're trying to be nice.
Anyway, Rupert?
They are very loyal. They know everything about... They know more about the show than we do a lot of the times.
Yeah.
But no, they're just very... It's weird, because when I kind of first joined, obviously I didn't know who I was, and the following year they stop you on the street and they know your name, they know everything about you. And,
wow.
And I did a play at the beginning of the year and lots of people came to see, which is amazing. They're so supportive, not just about
the show.
That's so
cool. It's like you're in a pop band.
It's
a twisted one.
Yeah. No, it is very cool, especially in France, because a lot of them stay in the same hotel as us and they
follow us
around.
Oh my God, it's actually a bit freaky.
And they give you gifts and stuff as well. I had a tapestry cushion cover given to me once with me and Arthur, which I haven't displayed.
That's what I would have, if you asked me what I thought the Merlin fan would be like, they would definitely be into tapestry. In fact, I've got a feeling that a few of them are listening right now. Hello, hi, welcome to One Extra if you're brand new. Big warm radio embrace right now. I know I'm sitting opposite some of your favourite people. Angel Coulby, who plays the wonderful Gwyn, and Rupert Young, who plays Sir Leon. So if you've got any questions, you can tweet us at One Extra, 1XTRA, or you can text me 88111. If you've got like this burning desire and you just don't think that I'm representing right now, I'm going to play some music. It's called Anticipate by an artist called Scream and Sam Frank. Enjoy, but feel free to get in touch. Starting to slightly regret asking for questions. I don't understand any of them. It's like a secret Merlin code. Oh gosh. I am joined by some of the cast of Merlin. You may watch it on a Saturday night with your takeaway. Someone's just literally written this. Maybe it'll make sense if you're hardcore Merlin. That's why they kept the sword after they killed off the round circle. Huh? Question mark. The stones spell Titiana. And are they supposed to float? Does that make any sense?
Absolutely no sense.
Cool.
Nothing.
All right, perfect. No, that's totally what I wanted. BBC Radio 1 Extra. If you do have a question, please get in touch, 88111. But I would like to say hello to the 25-year-old Merlin fan who's working in a bank and he says that he's a really cool nerd.
We didn't want to put his name down.
Not into tapestry, though. Not into tapestry,
okay,
I don't think. So tell me a little bit about your, like, sort of actual everyday lives rather than your characters and riding around on horses. I just seen the amazing castle, by the way, that's in France.
Yeah.
Oh, awesome. My gosh.
I know. It's like a fairy tale.
Basically, you're never going to grow up, are you now?
No, well, we don't really as actors, do we? We sort of play for a living, so we don't really... We're not expected to have to grow up.
That's cool.
Which is nice. Yeah.
So you mentioned, Rupert, that you did a play earlier on this year. What was that about?
It was a musical.
Okay.
Which was...
why did you squint?
No, because there's always people...
Give us a song.
A musical, I'm not going to do that. It's far too early. I did a musical at a place called the Southwark Playhouse, which is a great theatre near London Bridge, and it was a musical by Stephen Sondheim, and I played the lead in this about a guy who's 35, so I was playing a bit older than I am.
Okay.
Who all his friends are getting married, and he doesn't want to get married, and it's all about the pros and cons of marriage. It was an amazing show and a great opportunity to sing and scare the living daylights out of myself. Try not to swear there, so I can't talk.
Oh, yeah, be careful, guys. No. Come on, we weren't expecting that from Merlin cast members.
Yeah, sorry, scared the hell out of me. I can say hell.
Be careful, I'll get my tapestry out.
But I haven't got one. I want a tapestry.
You'll get one now. You'll get one.
Yeah, I want a tapestry, but not from the one who asked that weird question that we didn't understand.
Okay, fair enough. All actors, though, they do like to kind of, you know, ones that consider themselves true artistes, like to mix up the idea of telly, film, and the live scare factor, like you said, of theatre. Do you think Merlin will ever go to the stage?
Oh, who knows? I don't know.
That could be quite
There's
cool.
already a musical called Camelot, isn't there?
Oh, yeah. Which right, I think they're bringing... I think they're bringing back.
Are they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're up, right? Camelot, of course.
We seem to have inspired lots of other... Maybe it wasn't us that inspired it.
It was us.
I think it's probably you and me, actually, independently. Yeah.
That's a good song. That's good lyrics.
Oh, right, so it's going to be all about a single then, is it? What's going on with Angel?
You never know.
I like it.
Can you sing, Angel?
She can. Oh, she's very, very good.
I think Gwen could be very marketable.
Maybe. I started playing the ukulele as well, so maybe I could like get that in somewhere.
Amazing! We love Rupert the ukulele. As well. Do you?
Yeah, we do a little. No, we haven't actually played together.
We haven't had a jam session.
We will, though. No. We will.
That is so cool. In a big castle, just hanging out in between, eating a banana and playing the ukulele.
It should be a loop, probably. Yeah, probably more apt.
Someone, Nat, would like to know if you're going to be doing, you specifically, Rupert, some more theatre. Did we cover that?
I would love to. At the moment, I haven't got plans to, but it's definitely something I'd like to do as much as I can.
Oh, so, I'm enjoying this next question. So more plays for sure.
Yeah.
Are you ready for this one, Angel? It wasn't from me. It was from Merlin fans, like Merlin Official. Is it true that you have a romance with the sexy Bradley Cooper?
Who's Bradley Cooper?
Oh, it's the guy from The Hangover. I like him.
No, but bring it on. Bring it on. Bradley, if you're listening,
Oh, okay, so she's single. This is good. This is what we wanted to know. A question for Angel. Now that Gwen feels guilty about Lancelot's death, will it change her relationship with Arthur?
Well, this series does focus a little bit more on the love triangle between Arthur, Guinevere and Lancelot. So possibly, yes, keep watching and you'll see.
Legend love triangle. Amazing. I've got to say goodbye because the news reporter is standing behind you guys and he's got to start in a few minutes and I've still got to fit in Rich Free too. But thank you so, so much. Come again.
Thank you very much for having us.
Keep us updated on all of your galloping malarkey. This is Rich Free 2. Just been joined in the studio by two lovely cast members from Saturday Night BBC's Merlin. Don't go anywhere though, we've still got loads more.